A question that comes up often is whether soy-based foods have any beneficial effects in terms of reducing the risk of developing cancer, or potentially detrimental effects in terms of increasing the risk of cancer. And so one of the things that's interesting is that soy itself is genetically modified 95% of the time. There was a study that came out a few years ago looking at actually genetically modified corn, not soy per se. What they found is that when you fed a rat a particular type of genetically modified corn, they developed cancers at a much greater rate than those that were not getting genetically modified corn. Additionally, when the rats were consuming the herbicide that is typically sprayed on genetically modified corn, they actually found that they also developed breast cancers at a significantly higher rate than those that were not getting that herbicide. So we know that the soy is sprayed with the same type of herbicide, and so one might guess that something similar could happen. But in fact, what we're finding is that there really does not appear to be any correlation in human studies with the development of cancer or reduction in cancer risk in most large studies. In fact, what we actually see is potentially even a reduction slightly in the risk of developing breast cancer, for example, particularly in Asian patients, their Asian population. So it's something that's very interesting. It's an area of a lot of controversy. We just don't seem to find that there is an increased risk or decreased risk in most populations based on moderate intake of soy, which is somewhere between one to maybe up to three servings of soy per day. Now, that's taking whole food versions of soy, like tofu, edamame, and soy milk. We're not talking about the extract versions of soy that are often found in things such as soy burgers and soy hot dogs and soy protein powders. Some of those things, particularly in the laboratory, have been shown to increase the risk of developments of a variety of cancers. It may be because those particular soy extracts are more potent in terms of their estrogen-like abilities to stimulate the estrogen receptors on cells, which potentially could serve as a growth factor for cancer cells that are sensitive to estrogen. So interesting. There have been studies looking also at populations of ladies who have had breast cancer and their breast cancer survivors, who then are basically soy consumers versus less soy consumers. And they found actually that in that population of people who consumed greater quantities of soy, even though they were counseled to not consume large quantities of soy, had actually a lower risk of developing a breast cancer recurrence. So it seemed like maybe it was protective in that regard for that. But that is typically was in an Asian population, and there have been some follow-on studies of that. So we're still learning more about this. It's an area of controversy. In terms of prostate cancer patients, soy seems to actually potentially slow the rise of the PSA, which is the blood test looking at prostate cancers. That may or may not correlate with growth of the cancer in terms of slowing the growth down. It's something of controversy. It's an area that's of active research. My answer is basically soy does not appear to increase or significantly decrease the risk of breast cancer or other cancers. So I think it's relatively safe in the standard quantities that people would be having, somewhere between one to three servings per day.
In this field, a single decision can change a game. For a man with prostate cancer, a single decision can change his entire life. While I chose surgery, a less aggressive approach called active surveillance might be the best choice for you. Ask your doctor about a genomic test that may help you make the right decision. Learn more at yourprostateyourdecision.com.